Hi, today we will have a look at this industrial controller box from the flea market. So as a reminder, it was a 3 euros in the flea market. I found some information. It is a piece of street furniture. In fact, it is a controller for the advertising panels, the ones with the two rolls of ads that go up and down to show different ads. I had one like them open in my street not long time ago, and I did make a video about this, so I will link this video in the description, and we will get an idea of what it is coming from. So obviously we have two variable frequency drives, because we have one motor in the top and one at the bottom for the two rolls of paper. All this is controlled by a programmable controller here, a very compact thing. So about the resale value of the parts, these VFDs are about 150 euros at least on eBay, and the programmable controller is over 200 euros. I may keep the VFDs, but the programmable controller, I have no equipment to use it, so probably I will sell this. So the case is made with a steel piece, bent like this, and a plastic cover, a U-shaped plastic cover. It is interesting to note that they did not bother removing the protective layer over the plastic. So maybe I will keep this part. I will cut it in several parts, and I will keep the bits for possible reuse of plastic. On the back side, we have a whole bunch of pop rivets. Most of the stuff is assembled with pop rivets, so it will be a pain to take apart. I did a test drill one of them. They are not too hard. They are aluminium, so it is not too hard to drill them. And here it is interesting to note, we have two computer case screws for one device here inside. So I do not know if it is it was replaced maybe at some point, and they did drill the rivets and put screws instead of it. At the back, at the top here, we have a fan with a protective grill. And at the other side, we have plugs. So I will show you now this plug panel. So on this bottom panel, we have the plugs on the manufacturer plate. So as you can see, there is no marking whatsoever about the plugs. The manufacturer plate says Arcomat. It is the brand of the thing. I will link their website in the video description. There is here a phone number behind this masking tape and a 4-digit serial number. It is called a box, two variators, power 360 watts, made in 2011, it seems. So about the plugs, we have an IEC plug with fuse. As you can see, it is not well attached at all. We have RJ45 plug here. We have three round weird plugs and one square weird plug. So according to the internal wiring, the square plug is where you connect the motors. And the round plugs are inputs to the microcontroller. So it must be sensors inputs for end of course sensors or something like this. And as you can see, it is just a stamped metal piece, bent and stamp, no marking, nothing. Quite not a terrible job here. So now we will unscrew this cover and see what we have inside. Okay, now we can open the cover and we will have a look at how it is made inside. So in fact, this thing is a little bit how you're doing. It is not really well made, as you will see. Quite approximative work. So there is only one screw to attach the cover, and it goes right off. So what do we have? We will start from the top. We have a fan. We have two VFDs, which are screwed to a metal plate, as you can see here, with self-tapping screws, and they are not even perpendicular to the plate. And the screw in the middle here, you will not be able to see it probably, but the end is completely straight. It is quite a bad work. So, and I know the VFDs were not replaced because their serial number are following. So the screw here at the bottom, as you can see, it is completely ruined and stripped. I will probably have a lot of problems to undo this one. As you can see, quite a bad work here. Okay, so we have two VFDs. We have here the Omron micro, programmable microcontroller with a sticker here for a software number, probably program number inside this. It is connected to this, it is called an interface board with two ribbon cables, and here are connections to the wirings for controlling the VFDs probably and the sensors outputs, inputs more exactly. Here we have a big grounding bus bar in copper. And what else? We have 24 volts power supply here for the microcontroller. And we have a mains filter. Mains input filter. On this panel you can see this LG45 wiring. It is not very well attached, floating in the breeze. This also. All the wires are in a two wire trays. They are superposed, one of the other one. This one is glued on the cover of the other one. It looks like all the power, so the power input to the VFDs and the output to the motors are in the bottom tray, and all the control and signals are on the top tray. So about the VFDs, I did figure out quite easily the wiring. In fact, if you remove this cover, we have this top PCB is probably all the control signals to remote control the VFD. So I need to find the user manual and study it. I hope I will be able to use them in standalone mode. Here we have one black and one blue wires. They are the mains input. We have these three wires here. It is output to the motor you are controlling. And of course, all at the bottom, grounding wire. This must be a plug for injecting some program, maybe, in the VFD. I hope I will be able to use them because they are pretty interesting. So I will try to show you the specification on these VFDs, like so. So they are tiny little things, but probably quite convenient because model number here, as you can see, they are for 0.37 kilowatt motor peak and 0.25 continuous probably. Input one phase mains and output guys three phase 0 to 230 volts 0 to 400 hertz. So yes, they are probably good for powering aircraft equipment, but it will be not isolated from the mains. So if I want to use them with aircraft equipment, I will probably get an of course it will not be completely safe. I will probably try to find an isolation transformer at least mains insulation transformer to isolate this from the grid. Weight is 0.6 kilograms, so a very tiny thing. Here you have a serial number, so as you can see, this one is 391, and the other one is 392. So the two things were made together, shipped together, and installed in this together. Interesting. Of course, made in Japan, you even have here the address of the company in case you want to check it on Google Earth. The backing plate is here is a heatsink. And about this VFD, and you will unplug it as anyway I am going to strip this completely, so let's undo it. Easy enough. It is an Omron, and here are the specifications. So you have a number of inputs and outputs here, and it is possible to stack optional modules on the side here. In fact, I did check them on eBay and I saw optional modules for it. You can extend this thing. Here you must have some kind, yes, a little plug. And these yellow things here are locking device to allow plugging and securing extension modules. Power supply here with this small plug and backup battery here. I do not know if it is to backup the software you inject in them, probably. Or real-time clock, maybe also. So it will be a good thing to sell on eBay as it is a quite proprietary thing and I have no real use for it. You can do the same thing with Arduino. Of course, this is way more reliable, but you probably need special stuff to program it anyway. Here, you can see if I leave this cover, we have a special plug at the bottom. So you probably need at least a special cable to connect it to a computer and inject the software to a computer, or maybe a standalone programmer box, not sure. So here this is. So apart from this, I will now start to take everything apart. The most of the work would be drilling the rivets, the pop rivets at the back. As you can see, everything is attached with the pop rivets. There are these terminals here. They are interesting because, in fact, they are screwless terminals. And you need to insert some tool. It was out of frame. It was perfectly out of frame even. So you need in fact to insert a tool and you are able to remove the cable. I will probably keep all these cables because they are terminated with these metal things. So it would be convenient to reuse them. Yes, in fact it is quite easy to take apart. So now the work will be to strip everything down and try to figure out how to use the VFDs in standalone mode. It should be nice if I could find a little three-phase motor for this purpose. It should be interesting. And maybe insulation transformer also. Of course, I am very precautious and I know what how to deal with it without killing myself. But it will be interesting to play with them. I hope this little keyboard allows to set all the parameters you need. Or maybe also you can get a quite simple protocol to drive them with this signal input. So it will be interesting to find out. For now, I have some disassembly work ahead. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.